Hey Nathan, it's Wednesday, January 21st, and I think it's time for another Why Is It Wednesday? This Wednesday's topic is, why do we hold hands? We all know the standard hand-holding styles. The classic, the interlaced, the just the pinky, the it was just my hands the whole time holding each other, this is kinda awkward. But why do we choose to clasp mitts as a form of symbolic gesture? I have to admit, I couldn't find much in the way of like hard science research on the matter, but from what I've studied and my personal conclusions, I've decided that there are two main causes to hand-holding: biology and culture. Like a lot of things that have to do with the brain, hand-holding has that nature and nurture dichotomy. So looking at the actual physical interaction, when you hold hands with someone, you're touching a very sensitive part of your body to that same very sensitive part of the other person's body. Like lips and other sensitive body parts, it feels good to have them stimulated, and so holding hands causes a mutual stimulation. Yay, nerve endings! Like I said, I couldn't find a whole lot of research about this, so I don't know if it's been studied, but I bet a small amount of oxytocin, aka the cuddle hormone, gets released when holding hands. Oxytocin is seen as a feel-good bonding hormone, and I don't know, I get good feelings when holding hands with you, Nathan, just like when we're cuddling or hugging. So possibly holding hands is just like a long-lasting hug that's more manageable spatially. I could kinda see a connection there, so yay for feel-good hormones! Culturally, hand-holding is much more subjective. As a very general symbol, it's a sign of closeness. I see it too as kind of putting yourself in a vulnerable situation, like I'm giving up the use of a very important tool of mine just to make a visual statement to the other person I'm holding hands with and others who may see. But there are differences across cultures as to with whom you would hold hands. Individual preferences on their comfort level of holding hands will vary everywhere, but most cultures have a certain standard when it comes to holding hands. Here in America, and I'm assuming it doesn't vary too much within other Western cultures, handholding is most symbolic when done by a couple. It can be a simple sign of affection to the other person and a non-intrusive sign to other people that the couple is together romantically. I have also known platonic female friends to hold each other's hands, particularly when they are inebriated, woo woo, again as a sign of closeness or affection. However, most in our society would assume two men holding hands to be romantically involved. Also, a group of people holding hands can be symbolic of a strong bond between them and can even be reassuring or strengthening. Like, isn't that what they did at the end of Guardians of the Galaxy? Parents and caregivers will also hold hands with children, sometimes just for practical safety or control, but also for affection and comfort, and I've seen children imitate these reasons with each other. So now in some African, Asian, and Arabic countries, hand-holding is more common amongst friends and is not exclusive of the male gender. It is an open sign of friendship and respect for two men to be seen walking down the street together holding hands, and is not necessarily considered a sign of romantic intimacy. Probably one of the coolest things George Bush ever did during his presidency. Well, cool. The only thing is, I wish Bender ever wanted to hold paw hands, because her little paws are just like the cutest, tiniest little things, and I just want to squeeze them and hold them forever. Nathan, we'll see you on Friday.